that y'all see it. Y'all see it. You could do it, do it. Like, we're not gonna sit back 10 years from now, like, you should have done it.
I think nobody would know that unless you're actually in that situation, like on the court.
Perhaps I have such special needs. I wondered what was wrong with me. My friends all fall so easily.
Oh.
Oh, this is amazing.
I think I got a poke bowl, and inside is like pickled cucumbers. I got sriracha chicken on the side, fried chicken, I think. White rice, some kimchi, spicy green sprouts, some seaweed, and corn, I think. Yeah.
So I stole one of your pieces of chicken, the sriracha chicken, sriracha barbecue chicken. I got the kimchi poppy bowl, comes with white rice, seaweed, corn, salmon, fried onions, scallion, and I'm missing one thing, I think. Oh, and spicy mayo. Yeah, spicy mayo. Spicy mayo makes everything better.
I got that too.
And then we also got the Korean corn dog. Your top five players in the world.
In the world.
NBA, WNBA, college, high school. Favorite. Top five favorite players.
Number one, probably like LeBron. For LeBron, number one. Number two. Liz Cambage. I like watching Liz Cambage.
She's an animal. Not playing this season.
I know.
Opted out. Seriously need
number three. I like watching Luca. He's really fun to watch.
Yeah. Yeah. I think he's after last night's game winner against the Clippers. Showed he had a ton of heart. Mm-hmm. Ice cold veins. Also, they showed a clip of him not listening to Rick Carlisle in the huddle before the play, mm-hmm. and he was doing bottle flips.
Uh-huh. So I didn't know he had like an accent.
Oh.
I know he's from
Europe. His family's from Slovenia. Mm-hmm. And I think he played in Madrid most of his life. Mm-hmm. I could be wrong. But second best league in the world, and he was MVP at like 17, 18 years old, and people couldn't believe that he's doing so well in the NBA right now. His game is tailored for the NBA game, in my opinion. So you got Luka, Liz.
And LeBron.
Bron. And two more.
Maybe Diana Taurasi.
Taurasi's the GOAT.
Mm-hmm.
You see her the other day? The clip of her. I think she was talking to the ref.
No.
Ref said something to her. She said something back. And as she's walking away, she was like, you know what? I'll see you in the lobby. But you know, they're in the wobble.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I think that ref probably got beat up. So that's four.
Mm-hmm.
And one more. Anyone in the world. You know, anyone in the world.
I guess I'll put you last.
All right, that's good company. Let's see. DT, Diana Taurasi, LeBron James, Liz Cambage, Luka Doncic, and Uncle Vinny. All right, that's good company. All right, that's really good company. All right, the next thing. We'll keep it basketball. What is your favorite move? Or shot, or whatever, thing to do on the basketball court. Like a signature move.
It's the step back.
Step back?
Mm-hmm.
I can see that. Now, who has the best step back in that you've ever seen? Not including me.
Me? No, me.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Best step back? Harden.
That's fair. The man that pushes all the rule book boundaries
mm-hmm.
to his advantage. People hate it, but I think it's great. I think it's great to find a cheat code and find loopholes, and people hate the way he plays, but I don't know, he's amazing. He's amazing at what he does. Okay. So This is a question I got from another podcast. Who was the hardest person or the toughest matchup you've ever had? And I know your career is really young. You know, going into the eighth grade, hasn't been a lot of exposure to a lot of different talent. So you play in NEPSAC AA, which is considered one of the top leagues, high school leagues for girls in the country. So, you know, name one person right now.
It hasn't been like that hard.
I hear you.
It hasn't been that hard, but it was definitely good competition.
Right.
I don't know.
Can't name anybody. No one's ever fried you. Is that what you're saying?
I don't know what team, but she plays in NEPSAC. She's just playing like pretty good defense. It was really hard to like, we were winning, but it was really hard to like get by her for a little bit.
Okay. You remember which team it was?
No.
That doesn't help. Can you think of someone, maybe even in practice, in your practice, like just toughest covers?
Lauren Hughes from Nobles.
Okay.
Really good defender in practice.
Yep. Going to Bowdoin mm-hmm. in the fall. Yeah, she's a incredible on the ball defender. Well, the toughest person you ever had to guard? Anywhere.
Anywhere.
Like in terms of, you know, in practice, in tournaments, in games?
Practice, probably Caroline Ducharme.
Oh, UConn bound?
Yep.
Who I think is a once in a generation talent.
Mm-hmm.
6'2 shooting guard. Shoots from 35 feet out if she wants, off the bounce. Yeah, no, that's a tough cover for
5'4
seventh grader.
Eighth grader.
You were seventh grader last time you were guarding her in practice. Yeah. No, that's a tough cover.
I back up, I get a big on me, and you know, when the bigs are like backing up like this, you're like, ooh, I know, I got him. And knowing at that time in my life, I had zero handle, like I couldn't handle the ball at all. I'd act like I was coming up,
yeah.
And I'd just shoot 35 footer
and pull up
and make it.